Hello everyone, welcome to Ultimate Diecast. My name's Tyrone, and coffee break's over. Let's get on with the second half of a video I started with the name something like Let's Make It Dirty. We kind of have with the Demolition Derbies. We'll continue on with an off-road. I believe this is the first off-road I've got from Johnny Lightning. 999 Special Corporate Blue is the colour of this dirty old bird. 1969 Plymouth Roadrunner. I've seen a Plymouth Roadrunner before, but not like this. Muddied up all over. Practically a time capsule, this casting was introduced as one of the earliest Playing Mantis muscle cars back in 1996. It has not been produced in over 23 years. I love it when they bring out old castings. I'm not sure I saw the original, but my all-time favourite brand of Matchbox, I wish they'd bring out some old ones again, or remake them as they were, but you know, you can't have everything. Let's get this off the card. What else to tell you about it? Not much. It's release two, and yeah, let's have a look. Again, there's the card, slightly bent by me, but that's all right. That's the back. I know if you're into keeping everything on the card, you might not see the back of that card, so freeze frame if you wish. Let's have a look at this beast. It's definitely a mud brown. Big old chunky tires. Do they turn though? Maybe. They rub. Good looking car. Open that. Oh gee, I don't want to do that. There's some resistance there. Nope, you've seen an engine before. No, I will leave that down. Yeah, I love the contrast to the blue on that mud brown. Dirty old bird across the back. Oh, does that? No, surely. No, doesn't. Really thought that boot lid was going to come up, but nope. 69 on the side, a few sponsors up and down the sides. Yeah, I like it. It's the same with the Demolition Derbies, isn't it? I'm at sort of hit and miss whether I'm going to pick them up or not, and then I start to walk away from them, and then I thought I'll probably never see them again because they're hot and cold in our shops. Sometimes you see them glimpsingly, fleetingly, and then you'll go months and months without seeing a single Johnny Lightning. So the general rule of thumb is buy them when you see them. If you see them, if you can, we'll clean things up with street versions. This is blacked out of the Street Freaks Johnny Lightning. Midnight black, but I'm not sure about the white. Kind of the running theme of the last video and this video is pretty much all of these cars I wasn't sure if I should get them, but I did. Low maintenance and easy repairs popularized these vans for businesses around the world. Did I tell you what it was? It's a 1976 Chevy G20 van. It's as heavy as you like, but I'm not sure about the white. Here's the back. It felt like it wanted to rip loose and fly across the room. There's your card. Same as the other, I think. Zingers, I have a few zingers. Let's take a look. Ooh, yeah, I'm not sure about that. Gee, it's wide. See, I'm comparing to this, and it's pure black, and I love it. Black Bandit in silhouette-ish on the side. But, I don't know. Would I take a paintbrush to the white? Is it that simple? Yeah. Gee, it weighs a ton. Cool interior. Can actually see quite a bit in there. Full-on steering wheel. Can you see? Anything I can? No. No. That is a hefty little thing. Undecided. Maybe it will grow on me. Maybe they'll do it in a slightly different colour and I'll buy another one of them and then it will grow on me. That's usually how it happens. Put that up there. Right, let's move on. Wasn't sure about this colour. I love this casting. It's a beauty. 1965 Chevy Suburban from Auto World. We're saying new casting, but this is about the fifth colour of this one I have. Muscle Trucks Light Green. There's the back. Let's get her open. Facts. This is the first release of our all-new casting. Don't quite agree with that. We even toured the correct Chevy dog dish wheels. Alright, the Chevy Suburban was first introduced back in 1935 as the Chevrolet Suburban Carryall. Big slab of a bonnet. That's all I'll risk opening that. Yeah, because they've given us an orange one and a grey one and a gold one and a red one and maybe another colour too. That's what I can remember off the top of my head. Great looking truck, wagon, carryall. I suppose it's of the age, isn't it? It's of the era. I'll put it in between the black ones to mix them all up. And this one, I thought, you know what, I might have had my fill of these trucks because this is possibly the 10th or 11th one I have now. And at first I thought, no, I've already got that one. But no, I don't. Well, I didn't. I do now. 2019 Ford F-150 XLT Sport. Funky colours. Iconic silver. This diecast is replicated with the XLT Special Edition Package stripes with the custom grille and a special 2020 colour. Oh, I see. Style side beds have flat sides. The flare side with the incorporated sidestep was not offered in 2019. Don't you know? I don't. Didn't. Pyong! Oh, there's such a lump. And no, you know what it looks like. I'll give it another crack. Oh, there we go. Yeah, see? Covers. You've got a splash of white paint on the cap of that radiator, or the top of that radiator, but it's just covers. Clonk. And the tailgate comes down on these. So you can pop your dog in there. All right, I'll get the next colour. Plugged out wheels. What's so special about the grille? I'm not sure. I'm not 100% familiar with this vehicle in real life, although there are a few zipping around the hills here in Perth. Big monsters of things, aren't they? Imagine being T-boned by that. Yeah. Not yeah, being T-boned, but yeah, it's a great casting. Being too T-boned, not so much fun. Let's get it all symmetrical. Hope you enjoyed these two videos. Always a pleasure to bring you new stuff and assault your senses with new cars. Pop the little billboards up the back there. Break up the blacks. It's a bit of colour in between. Magic. Awesome. Like, share, subscribe, and I'll see you next week. Bye.